nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Welcome everyone. So continuing from the last lecture about triangular lattices, now we're going to look at how MIT photonic bands or MPB could be used for 3D lattices as well as like maximizing band gaps. So the first kind of 3D lattice we might be interested in because it has a large band gap is the diamond lattice. And so this actually shows you how you can define a 3D lattice with diamond. And so the key thing is, first of all, that the basis is different in size than for the previous types of structures, which had size of one in each direction. But then second, you can see that the basis directions are essentially like y plus z, and then x plus y. And then we actually come up with a fairly complex looking list of special K points, but these can be also looked up in the literature in case you don't know them for the face center cubic lattice. And so it's not just the gamma point, but also the X, U, L, W, and K points. And so now moving on, you can see that for the diamond lattice, we're going to need to define like two unit atoms per cell, and then these will have a certain specified radius and dielectric constant, which we can define up here, and then they'll be at a distance of 1/8 x plus y plus z in the plus and minus directions, or so in other words, the distance between them will be 1/4 times square root of 3. And because this is a 3D calculation, we might want to use a slightly lower resolution. So instead of the 32 resolution per unit distance that we had before, now we use 16. So that gives us a 16 by 16 by 16 grid, or about 4,096 overall grid points. And we have a mesh size of about five bands to reduce the computational load. And then we can actually run the calculation using the run function. And now we don't use run TE or run TM because it's a true 3D calculation. So TE and TM modes are not well defined. And then the kind of final result that we get for the band structure looks like this, and I've just added kind of this extra yellow bar, but you can see that this matches very closely with the results that we showed previously for the 3D photonic band gap. And you can actually explicitly calculate the exact size of the band gap relative to the mid gap point, and you can see that the size is about 10.6%. And then you can also visualize the fields very easily. So you can see that the fields in this so-called Vis5D output, which is kind of invoked here, would have localization either at the high dielectric regions, which is shown in blue, or in the low dielectric region shown in kind of like this teal kind of color. And then the third band gap just above third band just above the band gap actually would be localized explicitly away from the high dielectric regions, which is kind of expected. And that's why it has more energy, and because the average epsilon is much lower. Now, in order to maximize band gaps, like the diamond band gap that I just showed you, then we can actually invoke what's called Brent's method. And Brent's method is actually a very effective way if you're doing a single parameter optimization to very quickly evaluate multiple options. And you can see from numerical recipes kind of how it works. So you would create like an initial bracket between two points, and you would assume that you have a concave function between them. And you would basically fit the parabola at the initial set of points that you calculate, and then try to evaluate it like right at the center. And then, of course, it probably doesn't exactly conform to a parabola. So then on the next iteration, you define like a tighter bracket, and then you would basically find the new optimum with the new parabola, and then repeat until the bracket is approaching your tolerance. And so this allows you to quickly find the optimum. And so you can actually implement this also numerically in Scheme. And so if you define that the band gap has a certain value as a function of radius. And so we're only optimizing radius of the spheres, nothing else. And then we basically would define the gap, retrieve the gap, and then basically run the optimization algorithm using this so-called maximize function, which is defined in libctl, which is part of MPB essentially. And then we could actually output the maximum gap. And then you can find that the true maximum would actually give us like a much larger gap size and a different radius than we calculated earlier. So that's a nice demonstration of how it works. And so in the next calculation or next lecture, we'll actually talk more details about what else we can do with MPB.